My name is Deontay Smith. I play O-line and I'm from Augusta, Georgia. I say at the age of around 4, my mom put me in like flag football. And that was like my start of football. That's the earliest memory I have. NC State, my true freshman year, when we won that game, it was 33-30, I believe. It was just a crazy environment. That's like me as a true freshman coming in. I'm like, this is crazy. I can't wait to get into the game. That's like a memory that sticks out of my head. Coming here, you know what I mean? There were definitely improvements that I needed to make and grow. My body definitely matured at ECU under our weight room development. And, you know, academically, I was able to get my econ degree with a minor in business administration. You know, I just want to be somebody that, like, help inspire some of the younger guys to, you know what I mean, go a little harder and, you know what I mean, inspire everybody else, you know what I mean, that, you know what I mean, anything can happen for you. And, you know what I mean, I just want my legs to be known. I was a hard worker, too.
A Blake Pro wide receiver, Greensboro, North Carolina. It was more of, like, just kind of a family tradition to play football. My dad played for a while, and then my brother played, so it was just something that we did. I was kind of, like, felt like it was destined for me to play the game. First football memory was probably playing with Oak Ridge Colts, Pop Warner team in Greensboro. I was a camp guy, so people weren't going to offer me off of film, so I had to kind of go prove my worth, and I was offered at ECU at the camp. So that was just, you know, something where I felt a lot of love from them. So once I committed here, it was kind of just something that I wasn't going to turn my back on. Coach Dudzik was a huge, you know, he was very vital to me and my growth, and we have a great relationship. And I would say Coach Houston, you know, made me better as a player. I would say the last game, that's kind of, you know, still fresh in my mind. When Snead, you know, threw me that trick pass, you know, that was something roommate to roommate. And that's like a brother to me too. So that's a play that we tried to get called like every single game. And when we called it and then we perfected it, it was pretty awesome to, you know, bring it to life. I would say just to be remembered as, you know, a true Pirate, you know, somebody who came in here as a blue collar athlete and put in the work. And, you know, as a receiver, I got to play, you know, at the same school as Zay Jones, Justin Hardy, Dwayne Harris, and all those people who have great legacies here. And I just want to say that when people ask about great receivers here, they would include my name, you know. Once a Pirate, always a Pirate.
Jake Verity, place kicker, Bremen, Georgia. Well, I'm from a really small kind of country town, and football is a really big tradition there. And when we moved out there, I'd been a soccer player my entire life growing up, and I'd heard here and there kind of coming up through middle school that, hey man, you should come out and kick, we don't have a kicker. So I mean, I molded over for a little bit, tried to play in eighth grade, couldn't do it. Ninth grade came around and I walked out there and started playing football and started kicking, and that's kind of where my career blossomed. My first major football memory was actually played safety my freshman year, and I was doing a tackling drill, and I think I was running the ball and one of the other safeties was coming to get me, and I ended up breaking my ankle pretty bad. And yeah, I'd have surgery on that, so that put me out for a year. And you can ask Coach Weaver too, I would have been a dog in the safeties room. Again, going to that small kind of rural school, I wasn't very highly recruited. I really had to push myself out there, and ECU came in late in the game. I talked to Coach Shannon Moore, who's at Wyoming now, and he was a special teams coach, and they had me up here for a visit, and I loved it. I met Worth and Davis, the kicker and the punter at the time in 2016, and they really brought me in, kind of showed me the ropes, and Coach Moore really believed in my talent and got me on the field a couple times as a freshman, and Coach Dahl showed me how to be a good college football player, and then Coach Houston and this new coaching staff really showed me how to be mentally tough, and all those things are huge aspects of my career that make me a great player. It's a tough one, but recently I've been thinking a lot about the NC State game in 2018. It was coming to the end of a really good year for me, and as you guys probably remember, we were down, I think it was 58-0 with 2 seconds left on the clock, and I had to make a 46-yarder to save the shutout. And I hit it, and their coach thought it would be cool to ice me, and he did. And I looked over there, and I was like, wow, really? So I went out there, and I hit the same exact ball and made it again, made it 2 times in a row and saved the shutout. And for me, that's a huge game because it really kind of, that was a low point for us. And the past 2 years here have been really special to me because of the progress that I've seen with everything around this entire program. Everybody here has really helped me a ton. As far as becoming a good player, becoming a better person, working hard. I credit myself with a lot of the hard work and the hours I put in behind the scenes, but couldn't have been done without my teammates and my coaches. And I just really think becoming a powerful, consistent place kicker here, I mean, there's people I can thank everywhere. And if I could, I would, but I don't have enough time in the day to get around everybody, so. I want to be known as one of the best players to ever put on the purple and gold, not just a kicker, but as a teammate, as somebody who helped build this program back up to where it should be, as somebody who was coachable, as somebody who was there for anybody that needed him in this building. And I feel like I was. I feel like I put 100% of myself into it, and I'm going to keep working hard to get 1% better every day. So once a Pirate, always a Pirate.